Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to week number one of the regular season for the Indianapolis Colts here. And this is episode number two of my franchise. And this is a huge game. First week one, Sunday night football up against Peyton Manning. Peyton Manning versus Andrew Luck. And it's going to be a huge game here. So many storylines behind this game, especially with Peyton Manning being almost a legend over at Indianapolis, and now here is his second matchup against them. Hasn't beat them yet, but looking to do that in week number one. And the Colts, they're going to be looking to beat Peyton Manning twice now, as Peyton Manning's homecoming in Indianapolis didn't go as planned. But the Colts, in real life, they were without Robert Mathis, but in this one, they will be with him. And the Broncos will also have Wes Welker. They added some pieces in the offseason, some huge pieces. I really like the Broncos' moves. Added a lot of defense and added another receiver in Emmanuel Sanders, who will go along with Wes Welker and Demaryius Thomas, also with Julius Thomas, and will be a wide receiver tandem to be reckoned with. So Matt Prater is here to kick it off, and let's see what the Colts can do. Griff Whalen up to take the kick, and it is off. And that is a very short kick. Here in Mile High, ball tends to travel a lot, and Griff Whalen's going to get out to about the 26-yard line. And that's going to bring in Mr. Andrew Luck, one of the great young quarterbacks here in the NFL, and we are privileged to see him today. So, let's take a look at the Colts' offensive line. Today's highlight is going to be on Hakeem Nicks. He's going to have a big game for the Colts to have a good game today. DeMarcus Ware is the highlight for the Broncos' defense. He's going to have to put pressure on Peyton Manning. And as you look at their secondary, Aqib Talib and TJ Ward, two of the biggest free agent acquisitions for the Denver Broncos. So, Andrew Luck dropping back to throw, going to find Hakeem Nicks. But it is dropped. Butterfingers right there by Hakeem. That's going to be a punt away. Enter Peyton Manning, the legend himself. And he's going to be looking to down his old team. So we're going to take a look at the Broncos offense here. And they have a really good O-line. But today's highlight is going to be on Demaryius Thomas, who's going to have a good game for not only himself, but for his teammates to also have good games. It's all going to depend on him. And to lock him down is going to be Vontae Davis, one of the best corners in the game. He's not Richard Sherman, because he doesn't talk like that. But, he's a lockdown corner for us, and he's going to try to lock down Demaryius Thomas. And Peyton Manning is going to fumble right there. And on 3rd and 14, Robert Mathis just comes out of nowhere. Arthur Jones recovers the fumble. Let's look at a replay right here. Peyton Manning jogging back to throw, and that wasn't even Robert Mathis. That was Eric Walden getting in on that sack, and Arthur Jones with the great presence of mind to just pick that up, as he was also there and probably got half a sack. 3rd and 6, Andrew Luck here. He's going to be looking to set up a screen, and he's going to get sacked right there by the Broncos defense. So we're going to have to settle for a field goal. Not the ideal situation on a turnover. You need to capitalize with touchdowns against the Broncos especially. But the Colts are now driving again. Andrew Luck is going to find his man. No, he's not. Reggie Wayne can't make the catch. And I don't know his first name, but Raheem Moore is going to make the interception. And Andrew Luck, terrible decision right there. You're going to see a lot more mistakes in this game. That's a spoiler alert. But Raheem Moore just steps in front of that slant. And an intelligent play by a great player on the Broncos. So 3rd and 10, Peyton Manning trying to make the Colts pay. Gonna try to look for his man. Gonna find Demaryius Thomas. Yeah, I believe that's Demaryius Thomas. But that's not gonna be enough for a first down. So the Indianapolis defense holding strong, holding the Denver Broncos to no points in the first quarter. Peyton Manning stepping back to throw. This one is to Julius Thomas, I believe. No, that's to Demaryius Thomas again, and that's a first down. 3rd and 16 now after Peyton Manning got sacked. Let's see if the Indy defense can hold here, as Peyton Manning has unlimited amount of time right here. Gonna chuck it up deep, but it is tipped by Josh Gordy. Or no, that is Greg Toler. And that's gonna lead to a Matt Prater field goal. Looks to be about 40 yards-ish. And that is gonna be up, and it is good. Matt Prater, one of the best legs. He had a record. He broke the record for NFL field goal right there, the longest field goal. And more bricks on Derek Rogers' hands. And that's going to lead to a punt away by Indy. Third and 13. Peyton Manning going to drop back to throw here. He's going to set up a screen. But he's going to shed off a sack looking for another man. But that is going to be Maurice Hughes? Something Hughes. And he's going to come around and make the sack. A great second effort. And that is going to be a great catch right there by Colby Fleener. And the Indianapolis Colts have 33 seconds left to put some points on the board. One timeout left, and that is picked off! Von Miller steps in front of that little stick play, and Anthony Costanzo can't get to him. Pick six for the Broncos. Von Miller, he did not have a good showing in real life against the Colts, but right here, he proves to be big as he read that play perfectly. Andrew Luck with another mistake. And that's going to make it 10-3. So, 16 seconds left now. The Colts trying to get something going here. They just want to get some points before the quarter ends. And Reggie Wayne, he was almost gone. But the Colts are going to try to hurry up back to the line. 7 seconds, 6 seconds, 5 seconds, 4 seconds. And spike the ball right there. And now here comes the field goal unit. Adam Vinatieri, 53 yards. And it is short. Just maybe by a couple inches. And that's going to mean the Broncos are going to be up 3-10 heading into halftime. Not what the Colts wanted to strike early. They had some chances, but they just couldn't capitalize. The Colts are leading the Broncos in all the major offensive categories except for time of possession. But the Colts are still in this game. They should be leading, but they're not. That was a huge fumble by Eric Walden. And then Peyton Manning is having a terrible day in the pocket. It's been collapsing, and then he's been holding the ball too long. As Arthur Jones right there, he got a sack. So 3rd and 7, Peyton Manning just trying to right this ship here for the Denver Broncos. They're leading, but not their offense has been anything but a well-oiled machine. But, oh no, that's terrible coverage by the Colts defense. Wes Welker breaks loose. Peyton Manning's going to find him. And that's going to be a 3-17 deficit for the Colts. 2nd and 10, Andrew Luck driving back to throw, going to find Derek Rogers. Breaks a tackle, almost breaks another tackle. But that's going to be a first down, huge for the Colts. 1st and 10, they need a nice drive right here to get back in this game and try to put some pressure on the Broncos. And I don't know what the hell that was. Reggie Wayne is going to, he went on a little out route. And then Chris Harris Jr., one of the best corners in the game as well. He's gonna get the INT. But the Colts defense still holding strong. Oh no, that's another interception. What do you know? That was just a weird interception, you know? Just one of those things. He just bounces off a Broncos defender's head. And then just kind of falls to the ground. Let's take a look at the replay. Kind of bounces off his head. And then, I don't know how that defensive tackle actually... our linebacker actually had the presence of mind to make that catch. But Peyton Manning's getting sacked again. This Indy defense has shown up so big for the game today. Prater is going to attempt a 43-yarder right here. And it is good. So, 20, as the Colts need to get a good drive going here. They're going to give it to Reggie Wayne. And 3rd and 6, good conversion right there. So 3 possessions down, they need to get a couple scores quick here. Reggie Wayne, another reception. And he's been Andrew Luck's safety blanket, and he's been working out very well, but Andrew Luck is going to go down with a sack. Getting desperate right here, and they need to go for it. Andrew Luck is going to heave one up. Over to Griff Whalen, and the cornerback jumps too early. Griff Whalen makes the catch, and the Colts have some life. Trent Richardson, stumbling. He's going to get over to the 1-yard line, and now he is going to punch it in. So the Colts get their first touchdown of the season. After 4 interceptions by Andrew Luck, they finally got one by Trent Richardson. And the Denver Broncos are up 20-10, pending the extra point. So, 2nd and 4 for the Broncos. Colts need a defensive stand right here. Peyton Manning, play action fake. That's a great pass to Emmanuel Sanders. That That was just a good conversion by the Broncos. Second and goal here from the 9-yard line. 5:18 left in the fourth quarter. Peyton Manning's going to find his man. I think that's Caldwell, and that's going to be another touchdown. So 27-10. Indy still has a chance, but not a very good chance. Hakeem Nicks makes a nice catch right there. He needed to have a big game, and he has had a pretty big game, but Andrew Luck just making too many mistakes. Dwayne Allen's going to make that catch. Going to make it first and goal from the 6. 340-ish left in the fourth quarter. Bradshaw can't get in right there. But from the 2-yard line, second and goal, that's going to be a touchdown to Dwayne Allen. And the Colts have a 7, or Reggie Wayne, excuse me. Oh, no. Yeah, Dwayne Allen. So 17-27 now with 3:32 left. Colts defense need to still come up big. I'm going to trust the defense right here. And we're going to punt. We're going to kick it away to the Broncos. Peyton Manning now. Monte Ball in the back. He hasn't had a good game. But this is going to be his biggest rush of the day, as that just came at a bad time. And now the Broncos are trying to run out the clock now. Second and 7, 2:37 left. We still have the 2-minute warning, so if we can get a stop, that will be awesome. And Monte Ball is not going anywhere right there. Third and 10. Colts defense rushing Peyton Manning, and that is going to be short. Caldwell is going to be taken down, and Indy's going to use their second timeout. So no timeouts left. 2-minute warning still left for the Colts. Hakeem Nicks with a nice catch. So the Colts are driving. Right before the fourth quarter's 2-minute warning comes, it's going to be a run to Ahmad Bradshaw, and he's going to get about to midfield. Third and 10 for the Colts. They need something big right here. They need another Griff Whalen catch. That's going to be a nice pass to Derek Rogers. Make it fourth and manageable. Andrew Luck drops back to throw, and he's going to get... Ooh! He had a man open, but the pressure just got to him too early. O-line couldn't hold it for him. That's going to pretty much do it for this game, as he just jumped that gap right there. I don't know what Ahmad Bradshaw was doing. He probably should have blocked right there. But the Broncos are going to escape out of here with a win. Like the real-life game, there was a bit of a scare for the Broncos. Got ahead early, but then just kind of took their foot off the gas pedal a little, and the Colts tried to come back, but they were just a little short. So Andrew Luck, not a good game, but the Colts still showed some heart, and Ahmad Bradshaw had 90 yards rushing. So some promising signs for the Colts. And Kobe Fleener has emerged as a very good player for us, and he will definitely be a part of our future. So take a look at the stats as you leave, guys. Thank you for watching. I'm really enjoying this series so far. I'm loving playing Madden. It's a great game. It's really fun to play. I'm sure I will improve my quarterback play as the time goes on. But for now, I'll bid you goodbye and have a great day.